Hey there, viewers! Do your gums bleed when you brush your teeth? Are your gums pulling away from your teeth? If left untreated, this can get bad really fast. In today's video, we'll be talking about periodontitis. What is it exactly? What are the stages? How is it different from gingivitis? What are its symptoms? We'll be discussing all of these and more. What is periodontitis? Periodontitis is an infection in your gums. This is usually due to bacteria that has collected in your teeth. If you leave periodontitis untreated, the infection will spread. But if you catch it early, you can avoid serious damage. Of course, this also means you need to maintain good oral hygiene to avoid getting the infection again. Do you brush and floss twice a day? What does your daily oral care routine look like? Share your experiences with the Bestie community in the comments below. Stages of periodontitis. Number 1, inflammation, gingivitis. The first stage of periodontitis sees the gums becoming inflamed. This is known as gingivitis. How do you know if you have gingivitis though? The first sign is your gums bleeding when you brush or floss. Along with the blood, you'll also see discoloration in your teeth. This is called plaque. The reason you have plaque is because of food and bacteria building up in your teeth. You might think, oh well, since bacteria are always in the mouth anyway. Well, you're right about that, but letting it increase is a recipe for disaster. This usually happens when you don't brush properly or floss regularly. Number 2, early periodontal disease. After gingivitis, you'll go through the early stages of periodontal disease. With this, you'll see your gums receding. What this means is there will be small gaps between your gums and teeth. These gaps or pockets, as they're referred to, become a place for harmful bacteria to grow. During this time, your immune system will try and fight off the infection. You'll continue to see blood while you're brushing and maybe even some bone loss. Number 3, moderate periodontal disease. If left untreated, you will continue to bleed while now feeling pain around your teeth. After a while, your teeth will start feeling loose. This is because they lose the support of the bone. As a result of the infection, there may be inflammatory responses in the rest of your body. Number 4, advanced periodontal disease. Now we're getting into the advanced stages. If you let the disease take over, you'll see that the tissue that connects your teeth start to deteriorate. The gums, bones, and tissue that support your teeth will start to fall off as well. When you have the advanced stage of the disease, you may not even be able to chew your food because of the severe pain you'll experience. This could result in you losing your teeth. Feel like you're missing out? Make sure you join millions of viewers by hitting that subscribe button and staying up to date on all our great Bestie content. Symptoms. There are a few symptoms you can look out for in the case of periodontitis. As I said a minute ago, your gums will start bleeding when you brush your teeth or floss. You'll also notice your teeth slightly changing their positions. Bad breath can also be a sign of periodontitis. If your gums are receding, swollen, and red, periodontitis is probably why. Plaque and tartar on your teeth are more symptoms. If you're feeling pain while chewing or have a foul taste in your mouth, you need to check with your dentist for periodontitis. Causes. The biggest cause for periodontitis is bad oral hygiene. The disease is common among people who don't brush properly, especially the parts of the mouth that are hard to reach. When you don't make an effort to clean hard-to-reach places, bacteria will multiply and form plaque. A buildup of plaque, if not brushed off every morning, will result in tartar. Tartar are when minerals are deposited on your plaque. This allows more bacterial growth and will spread towards your tooth's root. Because of this, your body's immune system will try to fight it off, resulting in inflammation of your gums. After a while, you'll start seeing those gross pockets we mentioned earlier. Harmful bacteria will take their place in these pockets and release toxins that will damage your teeth and gums. There are other things that can increase the chances of periodontitis. If you're a heavy smoker, you're more than likely going to suffer with periodontitis. This is actually one of the main causes. People suffering with obesity and type 2 diabetes also tend to have this disease. In the case of women, hormonal changes related to menstruation and menopause can weaken your gums. Diseases that impact your immune system, such as HIV and leukemia, could also end up causing periodontitis. If you're taking medication that reduces the flow of saliva in your mouth, you should also count this as a reason. Poor nutrition can also lead to periodontitis, especially if you're missing vitamin C. Genetics also play an important role. Before we move ahead, here's another video you might like. Strong immunity is essential for fighting off infections. Here's a video that talks about different ways to boost your immunity naturally. Watch and learn. Treatment. Number 1, oral hygiene practices. To treat periodontitis, your dentist will instruct you on how to properly brush and floss. The dentist will also suggest other oral care products like mouthwash. Just so we're clear, you need to brush twice a day with fluoride toothpaste. An electric toothbrush is also a smart option. Remember to brush for a whole 2 minutes. It makes no sense to brush for a few seconds and think that you've taken care of all the harmful bacteria on your teeth. You'll also need to floss at least once a day. If you can, avoid smoking or chewing tobacco. That goes a long way to help your teeth. Drinking a lot of soda can also be bad for your teeth. Experts say drinking soda can potentially lead to cavities and visible tooth decay. If you can't resist a Coke, use a straw. This keeps acid and sugar away from your teeth. It's also important you visit your dentist at least 2 times a year so that they can professionally clean your teeth. Actually, this deserves its own entry. Number 2, professional cleanings. When you get a cleaning done by a dentist, they remove all the plaque and tartar buildup on your teeth as well as the roots. They then polish the teeth and give you fluoride treatment. During a pro cleaning, special care will be taken to flush bacteria out from any pockets that may have already formed between the gum and teeth. There's a specific deep cleaning method called scaling and root planning. This removes all the plaque as well as any rough spots that might collect harmful bacteria. Number 3, antibiotics. If you have a gum infection, your dentist may have to prescribe antibiotics to treat it. This is usually done if your gums don't respond to cleaning and continue to suffer inflammation. Number 4, surgery. Worst case scenario, you'll have to get surgery. This is a step usually taken when all others, including professional cleaning and antibiotics, aren't moving the pockets in your teeth. If the inflammation remains in places you can't easily access through brushing or flossing, the dentist will look at surgery as your next best option. You'll have to undergo what's called a flap surgery. This is where the deposits under your gums are removed. You will be given anesthesia before the roots of your teeth are cleaned by lifting away the gums. The gums are then stitched back into place. Periodontitis can be prevented if you take good care of your teeth. There are certain things you can do to make sure your smile remains healthy and beautiful. Did you know scientists have discovered a drug that can fix cavities? You can also follow certain instructions to strengthen your teeth. Here's what you need to know. Watch 11 ways to make your teeth stronger. You can also try our video on the drug that fixes cavities and regrows teeth. Go ahead, click one, or better yet, watch both and learn more about oral health care. Did you know about periodontitis before watching this video? Did you ever struggle with this disease? Let us know in the comments below.